The following program is being brought to you by Loving's Moon, Tim and Jerry's Auto Sales, Garden Bowl, American Gratitude, Patrick Dugan's Coffee House, and AAA Loans and U-Haul. Two guys who like to express their opinion and don't give a rip what you think. From a hot LZ in the middle of BFE. Hey! A Power Surge Media production. This is JB Surge and Snipes Uncaged.
That's right. It is Uncaged, episode number 34. Thanks for joining us. However, whenever and wherever you may be listening, whether it's live here at Loving's Moon, live on our Facebook page, and of course anywhere you get your podcasts, except Apple's because they are a bunch of whores. Our top story today, apparently an Olympic runner is blaming a pork burrito for a positive steroid test. It's absolutely crazy. And so that's why you wouldn't...
A pork burrito?
A pork burrito for a positive steroid test. And that's why you won't see me compete in the Olympics.
Yeah, that's the reason.
So, yeah, there you go. Well, once again, episode number 34. I'm JB Surge. Snipes joining me as always. And, of course, our unofficial third guest, KanEquip Girl, is joining the show. KanEquip Girl, fresh off a trip to Elkhart, is that right?
Yes. Delivering a combine.
Delivering a combine.
Yes.
You put it on your back and you delivered that combine.
Send it. She sent it. Yeah.
I sent it on down the road.
Postage due.
Postage due, yeah.
Hey, I did get a check for it, so.
Oh, well, all right.
Yeah. Too bad it doesn't go in my bank account.
Oh. Well, they're only like, what, $25, $30? Something like that?
Yeah.
Something like that. No.
That's not even 1 mile delivery for you.
No.
Not even close. Well, I was gonna say, you go on to Elkhart. You literally just got back into town.
Yes.
Snipes and I went to my old stomping grounds down in Guymon, Oklahoma, where I used to do radio down at KGYN, and had to do some housekeeping things because Snipes, of course, like we mentioned before on the podcast, he does still work for the radio station that I used to work for, and so he got sent down there, and he's like, "Dude, I have no clue where this transmitter is at," and I'm like, "Okay, hold on, I'll show you."
Since you spent 16 months down there, so.
Well, 5 of my 16 months, so 16 months of radio down there, yes. But
okay.
I knew where to go, so we just, and we turned out one of our stops at the actual KGYN transmitter in Guymon was already where it needed to be, so that was a wasted trip.
Yes.
So.
The only thing we did was turn on the air conditioning in the studio.
In the studio, yeah, in the actual...
To keep the other transmitters going or whatever they are.
Yeah, exactly. So we got that done, and of course, we had to stop by the FM transmitter of KGYN in Liberal, where we made sure that the AC was running in there, which it was. It was wonderfully cool inside there. I could take a nap inside of that transmitter, but...
And that's because we predicted there's, like, how many radio stations out of that same room?
I want to say... 3 total.
Right. And so I'm assuming they went in there and turned everything on so that we could do that.
Yeah. So that's the reason why we took the trip down there. But the AC was working, of course, and then we also had to do some housekeeping things with the transmitter itself, and we got that done. And so apparently my former boss is completely happy, and you will be getting a bill.
Yeah.
For my work. Yeah. Cause
nice.
You don't,
that's yeah. right. I fed him lunch. My gosh. And then got him a milkshake that he couldn't drink because they decided.
They pulled it from the mixer maybe 3 minutes too early. And it was
just a block there of
was,
ice cream.
Yeah, it was literally some cream and then like two big scoops of ice cream. And yeah, that maybe a little bit of milk in there, but that's about it.
Way to go, Brahms.
Thanks a lot, Brahms. Guymon, Oklahoma.
Wow.
Jesus. Well, it is Guymon. It's the armpit of Oklahoma. Oh, geez.
So. Right. With hair removed. So it's
no,
just stubble.
Gosh, no,
it's just stubble.
Hair is not removed.
It's just stubble.
It is a full grass. Well, the amount of grass that we went through at that transmitter, it was not shaven.
That's nothing. Well, you go out to the transmitter, 1310.
Oh, and Scott
City, the grass or the weeds are shoulder level.
Yeah.
And so trenching through there, making sure you don't step on a snake is...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Snakes.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's...
Machete time.
It was road trip day for apparently all three of us, and hopefully the trips went well.
It drained you. Especially, yes, it makes you look forward to the weekend.
And
I was excited when I got back.
And I mean, Guymon is only 100 miles from Garden to Guymon and back. But yeah, it can take it out of you for sure. It was a rough one, but nonetheless, we're back here. Yeah, I did pull out the old intro because we are in a hot LZ because it is freaking hot outside.
105 was recorded.
Yeah, I want to say that was the high today. Yeah, at least 105. I still read 100 on my little temperature thing that my computer updated. I did an updater over the weekend, and then apparently they added a little temperature thing. Like, yes, hey, it's 100 degrees and sunny. Oh,
well, no kidding.
I can see. I now have to look at my misery every time I look at my computer, which is almost always because I use my computer for everything. Which, by the way, Garden City Wind Baseball, we're knee deep into the season already, and we're 9-5. We're clinging on to the ever so evading first place in the Mountain Division North. I think either we're tied or we're a half game back, depending on how Colorado Springs did. Which Colorado Springs is the other pretty good team in the division, and so it's
You heard today that they've added, or last night they've added
today. This morning.
This morning they added four more games,
home games. So
out of the 46, originally it was supposed to be 44. Then we got the two in Colby that came home games, so that's 46. Now you're adding four more, so we're direct at 50. I can count. 50. That's 50 home games.
Crazy.
Out of 60.
62, 63, something like that.
Lots of home games.
A lot of home games.
I'm excited.
Well, and that's the thing is that the reason why we have a bunch of home games in Garden City is because we get the sponsorships and we get the crowd. We get the money. We get the money flowing through Clint Leitner Field. And so it's. Yeah. So there's a reason why they pick Garden City favoring home games in Garden City, because we just get a better crowd, especially in the north, in the Mountain Division North. So
we're
busy with that. That's the reason why we're live here on a Friday night at Loving's Moon, which is only a couple of hours removed from karaoke starting at 9 o'clock. So if you're in and around Garden City and you don't have anything to do on a Friday night except die in this heat, and you want to get away from the heat, then you can come in and
die on stage.
Yeah.
That works.
But otherwise, no, it's nice and air conditioned here at Loving's Moon, and we'll be cranking up the music starting around 9 o'clock. So if you want to come out doing karaoke, I'm running the show this week and next week. I did confirm that for next week. So I am out of the OFAST trip. So Ronald Cut 12 will not be recorded from OFAST next week. So.
You won't miss.
You won't miss. So,
Know, you and KanEquip Girl can always do one on a Friday night.
That's true. We could do it. We need to. I need to figure out the logistics in that. But there's still trust me, for a Ronda Cut episode, there's still a lot. There's still a lot that goes into the quote unquote planning. It's the logistics of the fact, not the actual show prep.
Yeah, because I know that I sit there and I do my forensics and thespian exercises before we do a show. And when you're on Raw and Uncut, you know, you got to practice the F bombs and the things like that.
I know, right?
See?
Yeah.
So it takes practice. And
no, it doesn't.
I practice all day at work.
No,
a normal day at work.
Yes,
ladies and gentlemen, it does not take any work whatsoever. Let Snipes fool you.
Not on our part. Now, JB will do work.
Well, I was going to say, now, those of you who don't know, Snipes was a thespian. I mean,
yes.
You were.
I was part of the Thespian Society, International Thespian Society, and the NFL, the National Forensics League.
There you go.
The football league.
Yeah, I was gonna say the not so wonderful NFL. So,
Speaking of NFL, they're now looking to make their players, all of them, have the COVID vaccine before.
That's the thing is that they actually laid out guidelines as to those who are either vaccinated or not vaccinated, And if you're not vaccinated, it's pretty much, vaccine versus not vaccine, it's basically segregation. That's the simple fact. I don't care if people get triggered over that. I don't care if people get triggered over that notion. It is segregation. Yep. When it comes to non-vaccinated, players have to wear a mask. They can't be around teammates that have not been vaccinated. They have to sit at their own tables and the lunchroom. They can't catch
a football that has been thrown by somebody that's been unvaccinated.
Well, no, but I'm saying that they can't have any contact
that's
with any
ridiculous.
Other players.
It is
they
stupid,
can't,
isn't it?
Yes. They can't have any contact with any of the players. Oh, their lunches are going to be grab and go instead of actually prepared like a normal NFL lunch or meal is prepared. So, yeah, it's segregation. So, that's simple as that, folks.
I still have tickets to a game this year, and if they're requiring me to be vaccinated to go to the game, I won't be going, I guess.
I identify as vaccinated.
Yes.
You can't tell me that I'm not.
You self-identify.
I self-identify as vaccinated. That's right.
Me too.
So, eat shit, NFL. Oh, did I say that over the air?
Oh.
Mom will be mad because that went over Facebook Live. So.
Uh-oh.
Thanks for those who are joining us on Facebook Live, by the way. Hopefully the stream is coming through okay. But I wanted to get on Facebook Live because, you know, it's a Friday night. Not many people are knowing that we're going to be doing the podcast on random nights. Like, episode number 35 will be recorded literally, three or four days after this one is? Next Tuesday. Like, that's when the next podcast is going to be. That's a wrong cut. Never mind.
Yeah, we're going to wait a week because of unless you and KanEquip Girl decide to do something together.
Yeah, I'll still have to figure that out. Well, of course, not only that, but the following episodes, because now with those two extra home games, that removed us from, at any point, recording at all in the next week or in the week after.
Oh, yeah.
So episode number 35 may actually be not until, I want to say, the third week of July.
2022.
Not 2022.
Dang, that's a long time.
Yeah. I know.
No. Which is sad because we're going to be busy doing this. We're going to be doing the Garden City Wind, and we're going to completely miss our 1 year anniversary, which was July 3rd.
That's
right. Of 2020, which was it was the first episode of our podcast. So
that's right.
We're going to completely miss that, but we'll still do kind of a best moments though. Hopefully so.
Ooh, am I in the best moments?
No.
I didn't think I would be. Yeah.
No.
You're going to put all Joey on there now, aren't you?
He's only in one episode, and it's a Ron and Cut episode.
No.
For that.
No.
No.
So, no, he is not going to be in the best moments.
Please, no.
He is in the low lights.
Not the highlights.
Of Uncaged. Right. That's right, yeah. So, yeah, that's what's going on. We're going to try to get things put together.
As many as we can, we'll fit them in this summer. But things will go back to normal in the fall.
Yeah, once we get to the middle of August, then we're going to start uploading regularly. We're going to start becoming here at Loving's Moon regularly again. And, so that's
we'll have our big football kickoff show like we did last year.
Yeah, like we did last year. We'll have a week one start up there. And, of course, later on we'll I believe the third or fourth week of July, we'll probably do our NFL training camp episode. We'll talk about the NFL training camp and also my early predictions for the Chiefs 53-man roster.
Okay.
Since that won't be officially released until...
Where does Debbie think she's going?
I know. Where does she think she's going?
It's like, hey, Debbie, we're busy. You can't leave.
That's right. We're way too busy up here.
Heather's
up in this
here.
Business. That's true. Heather is here. Heather's
Debbie,
here.
You can't leave. Heather's here.
Yeah. Debbie, you can't leave. Heather's here.
Oh, look at that face. Oh.
Man, yeah, this is, she turned the back.
God, there's a, it's like cold on the back of her back. It's just.
Did a stiff breeze blow through here? the stiffest of breeze.
With that look, there is nothing stiff about it.
Yeah, anyway. So, yeah, that's what we got going up here. But our topic tonight is we're going to be talking about, No, we don't. she didn't even hear me good.
No. I know, she didn't hear me either.
So anyways, we're going to be talking about cover music, and it's quite an interesting topic because really, in our lifetime, we hear songs that may not be originals. Like, I think one of the most famous covers, especially in country music, is...
Yes. Oh.
What?
Yes.
Country music.
Is yes?
Awesome.
Is
oh,
okay. Yes. No, one of the more notable country covers is a Wagon Wheel, which originally, of course, was made extremely famous in the mainstream country world by Darius Rucker, former Hootie from Hootie and the Blowfish. The original artist, by the way, is Bob Dylan. So,
okay,
I did not.
Yeah,
know that.
And then
Bob
it was
Dylan.
Also covered by that
Old Crow Medicine Show. Yeah,
Old Crow Medicine Show.
Yeah, yeah. Which that's my personal favorite cover of that song. But yeah, funny thing. I'm going to get to a list of songs that I didn't even know were covers, and quite a few of them were from Bob Dylan. Like Bob Dylan wrote a lot of songs that were made famous by other people,
really,
by other artists. So yeah,
this is going to be fun.
It's quite the interesting. So, but I looked up while I was making my top 10 list of my personal best covers of all time, which we'll get to later on in the episode. I was looking up on Google about, I guess, some of the mainstream's best covers.
Yes.
And so,
okay.
I've kind of gone through here. Eric Clapton's I Shot the Sheriff. Remember
okay.
that song?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Believe it or not, originally covered by Bob Marley. Or original artist was Bob Marley.
Oh. So,
there you go.
Well, he had a reason to shoot the sheriff. He was holding weed.
Did he not?
That's true.
I mean, maybe.
It was just
Bob Marley and the Wailers. Yeah, first released the classic back in 1973 as a reggae tune. And then about a year later, Eric decided to take his take on I Shot the Sheriff. But he did not shoot the
deputy. And he had to shoot the sheriff because of the cocaine that he was carrying. So.
Wait, what?
We're talking about Eric Clapton.
We're talking about cocaine.
Yeah,
she heard Eric Clapton, and all of a sudden things...
She don't lie.
Things happened, just like Keller Leopold Insurance.
things happened.
Things happened.
All right.
By the way, that's not a free plug. Keller Leopold, you owe us money now. okay, well, have you ever heard the Run DMC cover of Walk This Way by Aerosmith?
Yes, isn't horrible.
Awful?
Horrible.
Stupid.
Horrible.
In this article, the top 20 covers, that was number 18, and I'm like,
yeah.
No.
Awful. It was originally original by Aerosmith.
Aerosmith, right.
Right, and I believe Tyler was in that, in the video with Run DMC. He's in the recording.
That's right. Yeah, technically, that cover was done with, like you said, Steven Tyler from Aerosmith, but awful cover. You know the song Proud Mary by Ike and Tina Turner?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Originally a cover.
By CCR.
CCR did that
right.
cover.
I knew that.
Yeah, I didn't know that one. So. Mm-hmm. Joe Cocker's a little with a little
help.
And
that was also covered by, I believe, a country artist. And I can't tell you who right off the bat.
I don't know. I wouldn't know. So. I've heard this cover before, Joe Cocker's with a little help from my friends, but I originally knew that from the Beatles, and that was who the original artist was.
Right, Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band.
Yeah. Cyndi Lauper's Girls Just Want to Have Fun was a cover. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
Yeah. Originally by
a guy
by the name of Robert Hazard. Apparently he originally wrote this song...
He got his name by hitting the hazard button on his light car.
No, believe it or not, amazingly, this song was originally written from the male perspective about women in the bedroom back in 1979 by Robert Hazard. So originally a very dirty song now. Yeah. But 4 years later, Cyndi Lauper decided to make it into a fun party song for the women. So
she did an amazing job.
I think so.
Yes.
Yeah.
No, there's something wrong with pink hair. I have a problem with pink hair.
But she sings good.
I think she has fun singing.
Yes.
The only thing
I don't think
she
she's a good
right
singer,
now,
but I think she's a fun. I think she has fun singing.
Yes.
Right. But the only thing she does good now is that those commercials for
eczema commercials.
Oh, jeez. Yeah. I was gonna. Yeah. No. Whatever.
I like Cyndi Lauper. She's good.
Okay, I didn't know Yeah, so, some of these people are just like, oh yeah, check out this cover by this band that did it better anyway. The Isley Brothers?
Yes.
Summer Breeze, apparently. Which was
Summer Breeze.
Yeah, originally by Seals and Crofts.
Seals and Crofts.
Right, yeah. Okay. But Isley Brothers apparently covered it, and I'm like, okay. No, I'm sorry. Nothing will beat the original, I'm sorry.
Okay.
It's just not going to do it. Apparently, this one's really popular cover. Adele.
Adele Shannon?
No, Adele, the pop singer.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah, you don't know Adele Snipes because you're too damn old. So Adele's covered Bob Dylan's Make You Feel My Love, which was also covered by Garth Brooks.
Yes.
I know. I want to say Billy Joel also covered the song too. I'm not sure. Another Bob Dylan song. I never knew that it was actually original from Bob Dylan. I originally thought it was from Garth Brooks, but I guess not.
So. Well,
but Adele apparently
you
a very
say those
cover.
Words. Back up.
Who knows?
Yeah. I'm just saying that's original. That's where I heard it from. But
okay,
apparently that is a Bob Dylan. Leonard Cohen's "Hallelujah," not a cover. That was originally from him. But apparently there's this guy Jeff Buckley who covers "Hallelujah." Well, and okay, first of all, every starting guitar student starts to know "Hallelujah" and overplays the fuck out of it, and it irritates the crap out of me. It's a great song. Leonard Cohen, I think, nailed it the first time. I don't think no other cover can even come close to the original.
See, and the
Leonard
first time
Cohen.
I heard it was from Shrek.
That was Leonard Cohen.
Okay,
yeah, that song, yeah. Mm-hmm. But no, Jeff Buckley, I got 15 seconds into the cover, and I turned it off, and I was like, nope, sorry. Leonard Cohen already beat you. Have you heard of Sinead O'Connor's Nothing Compares to You?
Yes.
That was covered.
It was covered. It was that's a cover by Prince, yeah.
Okay, so that's what I thought.
Prince originally wrote that one, so there you go. If you didn't know that. Johnny Cash is Hurt?
Yes. I thought
that's a cover.
I hate that song.
I hate it too, but that's a cover originally by Nine Inch Nails.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Nine Inch Nails made it in wrote it in 1995, and then Johnny Cash covered it in 2002, about 3 years before a year before he died.
I was going to say I don't think he's even had 4-inch nails.
Well, no.
So
the fucking band, Nine Inch Nails. Good grief. Jeez. Okay, I heard it through the grapevine. I didn't know Marvin Gaye actually covered
that
it.
That was covered by a bunch of people.
Yeah, I've heard it by not by Marvin Gaye. The Miracles was the original on that one.
I was going to say it was also covered by a bunch of little raisins on a commercial.
Yes, it was.
It was.
California raisins.
See, there you go.
Gross. Raisins are
they did
awful.
It amazingly.
Cartoon raisins.
They did it amazingly.
Raisins are awful. The song, you know, R-E-S-P-E-C-T, Aretha Franklin, that is a cover. It's originally by Otis Redding.
Okay, so. I can see that.
But the little...
And Dock of the Bay.
What's Dock of the Bay?
Dock of the Bay has been a cover before.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Well, I heard Otis.
Yeah. Yeah, no. But apparently the you know, very popular hook, R-E-S-P-E-C-T, that was actually her, she actually added that in herself, so that was not a part of the original cover, but, you know, she took it from Otis and then made it her own there, so. Whitney Houston's I Will Always Love You cover. Dolly Parton was the original artist.
I knew that one.
So. Interesting number of covers. I have some more here. These Days. No, that was Jackson Browne.
I don't think I've heard anybody else sing it than him.
La Bamba.
Oh.
Everybody.
Which was, everybody.
Richie Valens?
Every Spanish, whatever you are, whether it's Tejano, pop, hip hop, you've covered La Bamba. Mm-hmm.
Karaoke.
But apparently the most popular cover was by a group called the Los Lobos.
Yes.
And their cover was featured in the movie La Bamba.
Okay.
That was their cover.
But Richie Valens was the first.
Richie Valens was the one who wrote that song. So.
See, and I thought somebody else wrote that. It was a traditional hymn, or traditional song within the Mexican.
Well, know. It's pretty traditional now.
Yeah. It sure is.
It's very traditional.
See, and Los Lobos reminds me of that song. Now I can't remember it. I can hear it in my head. Something about heaven.
Oh, Los Lonely Boys. Yeah, oh, heaven. Yeah. That's right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That is not a cover. That was originally by the Los Lonely Boys.
Okay.
There's another one in here that I was thinking of. Hmm. Jeff Buckley's Hallelujah is on this one again. I hate it. It's awful.
Jeff.
Joan Jett's I Love Rock and Roll. A cover.
I want to say by Starship. Jefferson Airplane?
No. The original cover was, the original band was The Arrows.
Oh.
So, I don't know. I wouldn't know The Arrows.
Who are The Arrows?
Thankfully, Joan Jett was, yeah, I don't know who The Arrows were, but.
The Arrows went by when the Indians all
yeah,
gave up.
Yeah, I've never heard of them.
Yeah. No. Right. Yeah. When the Indians decided to turn in their arrows for guns.
Muskets.
Yeah.
Muskets. The Muskets.
Oh, that'd be a good band.
It would be.
Muskets? Right.
The Gunpowders.
The Gunpowders. Knocking on Heaven's Door.
Covered
by a lot of people, originally by Bob Dylan.
Gosh, Mr. Bob Dylan.
Bob Dylan was a terrific songwriter.
Is he still around?
Yes, he is.
Is he still alive? Wow. Jeez.
I don't know. I'm guessing.
I'm probably. That'd be something for you to look up over there. Or maybe I can look it up here.
Yeah. Wait, you have a computer? What? We were told we can only have pencil and paper. What's this about?
Yeah.
My wife told me I could only use telephone book, not my phone.
Encyclopedia.
Or what was the math? Or the math teachers, you know, like, oh, you're not going to have a calculator everywhere you go, and now we have it on our phones. Right. No, still alive. He's 80 years old.
See, there you go.
He turned 80. Wow. He turned 80 this year. So all yeah, right. May 24th. May 24th.
That's right. 80. He still got his afro.
No.
Okay.
No.
Only white guy I knew had a good afro. My dad, though.
Except for Preston Rackley for the Garden City Wind.
Well, oh, yeah.
He's got a tremendous afro.
Yes, he does.
My dad had an afro in the 70s. With all that thinning hair, he had an afro. I'll have to show you a picture.
I've seen the picture, yeah.
The afro, yeah.
I made the
In the same back year, you were holding a beer can.
I made the comment that... When we went to his viewing, just the day before the funeral, I mentioned that maybe we should put an afro back on him and so, you know, bury him with the afro.
Well, yeah, with a rainbow afro, that would even be better.
Oh my goodness!
I had one of those because I used to go to NFL games and wear it all the time.
So, yeah, yeah.
Just to tick off the people behind me because I couldn't see.
Can't see. Well, get taller.
Which isn't an option for KanEquip Girl.
No, it's unfortunate.
That's right.
No. I was going to say, if we stand side by side, we'll be, you know, cellular strength towers. So.
That's right. I bet everything is a stiff neck and a crotch to you, isn't it? Or you're not that short. Okay.
I'm not that short. Oh.
Stiff neck and a crotch.
That's Jason.
Yeah, that's Jason. Poor Jason.
Oh, Heather just called out her husband, Jason. That's funny.
We would get him up here, but he can't reach the microphone.
He can't reach the microphones, yeah.
I barely make it, so.
It was Ron in Cut 5 that Colin made that joke about him. Look, he just walked right under the table on the high tops, you know.
That's right.
When Colin and Gus were sitting at the high tops, he's like, oh, look, he just walked right under the table. Good stuff, yeah. So, yeah, cover music, it's different. There's some covers that are really good, some covers that are really terrible.
And I have a list of number one hits that were all covers.
Covers? Really?
They were number one originally and a number one hit as a cover. So they're twice
as well.
Well,
cough it up. What are some of the number one hits?
I've got to get my old man spectacles on.
The old man stuff.
Because I'm of that age.
It's unfortunate.
Yes.
So.
So, Go Away, Little Girl.
Huh?
Go Away, Little Girl which was a cover by Donny Osmond.
If you want me to leave.
Right.
Go
but
ahead.
But it was not the original. The original was Steve Lawrence.
Oh. See? But Donny Osmond made it famous. There you go.
They were both number one hits by both artists.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, I'll be nice.
I'll Be There.
By
Jackson 5.
Uh-huh.
It was covered by Mariah Carey.
Mariah Carey, that's right. Who's got a freaking... Who the heck's got a freaking, like, hair trimmer or something like that? Oh, like, what the... Oh, jeez.
Yeah, somebody's brushing their teeth.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
Tattoo.
Free.
Lady Marmalade was covered by Christina Aguilar and Lil' Kim. Was originally by LaBelle.
Okay.
Wow.
Let me see here. Lean on Me.
Oh, well, everybody's done a cover of Lean on Me. Jeez.
But it was original by Bill Withers.
Bill Withers, that's right. Yeah.
Okay. The Locomotion. Original by Little Eva or Eva. And the cover is Grand Funk Railroad, but there's others that have done it.
Yeah, people have done Locomotion.
Okay. Please, Mr. Postman.
Yes, there's plenty of covers of that one, too.
The original are the Marvelettes. Mm-hmm. The cover is the Carpenters.
Okay, yeah. Carpenters covering. Yeah. There you go.
Venus, original was Shocking Blue. Cover was Bananarama.
Yeah.
You remember Bananarama?
Oh, Bananarama. Yeah.
They were Bananarama. Ugly. They were
ugly. Grief.
When a Man Loves a Woman.
Michael Bolton?
Original, Percy Sledge.
Oh, okay.
So it was Percy not Sledge. Right.
Oh, yeah.
See, I know the Michael Bolton cover of that one, so.
Right.
I actually know both of them, so yeah. They were both good.
You Keep Me Hanging On?
Yes.
Which was covered by Kim Wilde, but the original was The Supremes.
Wow, The Supremes covered that one first. Yes. Wow. Or it was original. Wow.
Right.
So, I was going to say, I know the Kim Wilde version, but wow. Yeah.
Okay. Me too. And I Think We're Alone Now.
Tiffany
was the cover, but the original was Tommy James and the Shondells.
Huh.
Oh, wow.
Wow, Shondells. I thought it was the Beatles.
Now.
I tell you what, I tell you what, like, whether a lot of 60s groups, 60s, 70s groups were wrote some good music, but were just covered sometimes well.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, there you go. Number one covers that some were also number one hits originally.
So yes.
By originals.
Hmm. Yep.
Wow.
I used to have a 8-track of Tommy James and the Shondells.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, baby.
An 8-track, yeah.
And one of the best songs
Snipes
on there.
Snipes just showed his age.
It would click in the middle of the song. I hated that. I hated that.
Got the right matchbook.
Got the right matchbook.
That's to keep it from dragging. Yeah. But yeah. That's,
yeah, no. He just showed his age. That's
We still have an 8-track player and some 8-tracks because the wife likes the
kind of like some
because the wife likes Carpenters and that's the only way she could find it was on 8-tracks.
That's right. I remember that. had to buy an 8-track player on eBay because they just don't sell them anymore.
And the 8-tracks that we got had Japanese writing on them.
That is hysterical. Lovely. I love that.
Oh wow!
Yeah.
So that's when you know you're getting a good product when there's Japanese writing on it.
Right. Sony, Yamaha, Mitsubishi. Mitsubishi started out making torpedoes for World War II, and that's how the torpedoes that bombed during World War II or during Pearl Harbor were Mitsubishi torpedoes.
I was going to say, well, that was kind of the defense production. Is that what they call it? They just other companies just make stuff to help for the.
No, that's how they started.
Oh, that's how they started.
Airplanes and torpedoes. The Japanese Zero, the famous fighter from World War II, was a Mitsubishi Zero. So, that's
this
how
is
they
one
started.
Way to start.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, you tune in for some knowledge.
Or history.
Thanks for joining us on Uncaged.
One of the two. You got it.
Yeah, thanks for joining us on Uncaged. We're done here. no, we're not. We're far from it. I was going to say, I want to get to my top 10. Top 10.
Okay.
Mm.
Top 10.
Yes.
my top 10 best covers of all time. So there's some may surprise you, some may not. But I'm going to get to my first. So I'm going to get to my first cover of my top 10. Number 10 was I'm a Believer.
Uh-huh.
Originally by the Monkees, right?
Correct.
But I like Smash Mouth's version a lot better.
And I do agree. I like the Smash Mouth version.
Kind of adds that 2000 vibe to it, doesn't it? Just like that, just early 2000s, like.
But they threw that organ in there. That
yes,
from the 60s. So yeah.
Yeah, I think that's pretty cool. So, but yeah, I'm a Believer I'm a Believer by Smash Mouth, originally by the Monkees. Mm-hmm. And I mean, my Monkees cover wasn't too bad, but
no.
Smash Mouth, man. I mentioned this cover earlier for number 9, which was Richie Valens' La Bamba, covered by Los Lobos. I think their cover is pretty good. And if you listen back to episode 21, I use their track.
You used Los Lobos when you record?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, when we did episode 21 for The Day the Music Died, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, just play. It just kind of adds more to it, I think, especially with...
Well, you got to remember, what were they recording on back then?
Yeah, exactly. That's
the equipment they were recording on back then, it was a little...
Was a little prehistoric.
Right. They had tubes in them.
Yeah, exactly.
You had to wait for the tubes to warm up.
Yep. So there you go. Number 9 on my list was Los Lobos La Bamba, originally by Richie Valens. Here's an unpopular one, I think. Not many people may not know this one, but I have number 8. Do you know the song In Too Deep by Sum 41? Really popular punk rock tune.
No.
Yeah. Well, I like that particular song, except this guy's cover of it. This guy is Alex Melton, and he actually turned this punk rock tune into a country type sound to it. Okay. So how about that? Yeah.
Yeah, that doesn't sound punky at all.
Well, that's the thing. It's originally a punk tune, but he turned it country.
Well, it sounds good.
Yeah, sounds
I like
great.
It. Yeah, it's a really cool. It's a really cool.
I
cover.
Heard no steel guitar in there, though.
No, I mean this is not like this is not saying. Like country western, but I'm saying it's like it's a.
Steel guitar makes it western.
No, I'm saying it makes it more country. Yeah, but more country western. But yeah, no steel guitar fiddles. But
you got to remember, Amarillo by Morning is also a cover.
Yeah, that's right. I forget who the original artist
Chris
was.
Chris Ledoux.
Chris Ledoux, that's right.
Was the original artist, and then
somebody
George Strait.
Somebody wrote it, and then Chris Ledoux made it, and then George Strait covered it. So,
yep.
I wonder if Chris Ledoux is coming back at George Strait for...
I think he died, didn't he? Chris Ledoux?
Yeah, Chris Ledoux.
Did he?
Is he really? Wow.
Yeah.
I don't think he's coming back. Now, if he comes back...
His son's alive.
Okay.
Ned Ledoux is still alive.
Oh, Ned.
Yes.
Really? He named his kid Ned?
Yes.
He must have watched that one.
Yeah, on
Deliverance
right
too much and like Ned Beatty in it or something.
Hey, he sings just like his dad, though.
Does he really?
Horrible.
Yes. Chris Ledoux is amazing. What the hell?
What the hell?
What the hell? I'm just partial to George Strait.
Yeah, I am too.
Well, me too, but Chris Ledoux is amazing. And Ned Ledoux sounds just like him.
Oh. Chris Ledoux's no longer amazing. He's now fertilizer.
He's now Wow.
I know, right?
Yeah, right? Yeah, so that's number 8 for me.
Some people.
Number 7, originally by a guy named Mark Cohn, his song Walking in Memphis.
Oh, yeah.
I think was better done by Lone Star.
I agree.
Yes, I agree.
Yeah, I like this cover a lot more than Mark Cohn. Nothing against Mark Cohn, but man, I tell you what, I personally like that. By the way, Kathleen may not like my opinion as that because she likes that song originally by Mark Cohn. Sorry, Kathleen.
Is she here?
No.
Oh, she may be tonight.
She may be tonight and may also be listening.
Doing the karaoke thing.
So
we'll make her sing it.
She does an amazing rendition.
It only takes like four or five shots of Fireball, and she's up singing.
Well, yeah. She can sing Stone Cold Sober too. So I'm not going to be totally on that or totally on the train of getting her messed
smashed
up.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, she does an amazing rendition of it too. So if you ever come out to karaoke, you might hear Kathleen do "Walking in Memphis."
Okay.
Originally by Mark Cohn.
All right. So,
that's my number seven.
Okay. No, I was just going to remind everyone that we won't be because of the Garden City Wind and your job for the Garden City Wind. We won't be doing a podcast next week. So
yeah, next week and possibly the following couple weeks after, because we are going to be completely busy with that. So a lot of games going on. So do what? Yeah, we'll be here doing karaoke tonight and next week. And then the DJ that does it when I'm not here, Louie, he'll be rocking out the rest of July, since he is gonna hang it up.
And then you take over in August permanently.
Yeah. The first date I'll take over officially is July 30th. That'll be the last Friday of July. So, okay. But yeah, that's what we got going for karaoke here at Loving's Moon. My number six, you know, okay, this is probably one of the only songs that I actually like of Taylor Swift.
No.
It's her song, I Knew You Were Trouble. Do you know that song?
No.
I Knew You Were Trouble When You Walked
In? I don't
in?
Like Taylor Swift, so no.
Oh, man.
Nope.
Well, I like her, I like the song, but I think when another kind of crossover, these guys went, turned pop into punk. This is a group if I can speak right now, this group is called We Came as Romans, and they did a punk version of I Knew You Were Trouble When You Walked In.
Yeah, that's much better than Taylor Swift.
Yeah, I like that a lot better.
Oh yeah, it kicks ass. I love it.
That is awesome.
I love it. No offense, nothing on Taylor Swift. I mean, she did. It was a good song, but man, We Came as Romans just knocked it out of the park with that one. So
their other band name, We Were Corinthians, didn't make it. So
yeah, they didn't come as Corinthians. So.
Wow, did you hear the crickets? I mean, that was cricket. Oh, okay.
She laughed. Yeah. Thanks, Heather. So, yeah, that was number six, I Knew Your Trouble, by We Came as Romans, originally by Taylor Swift. You'll be happy to know that number five I picked up, the song is Man of Constant Sorrow, originally by the Soggy Bottom Boys.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Done by our favorite country a cappella group, Home Free.
Oh.
I am a man in a constant sorrow.
Did you hear that kind of like harmonica type thing? That's
acapella. All voice.
That's all voice.
Yeah.
Isn't that crazy?
They are amazing.
I love Home Free. So yeah, Man of Constant Sorrow, Home Free, originally by the Soggy Bottom Boys. How about that?
And they've done so many covers that have improved it.
Oh yeah.
100%. 100%.
There's some Eagles, Seven Bridges Road.
Yes.
I think is so much better.
I think
Home Free.
I can make a top 20 of the best Home Free covers easily.
Oh,
I mean,
top 40.
Yeah, I mean, they're just incredible country group. They do have originals, but their covers are quite impressive, and it's more impressive because it's all done by voice, no instruments, nothing. It's all voice, which I personally enjoy. So that is number five on my list. This one, Snipes, I know you'll personally like as well. Is a song by Rich Mullins.
Oh.
His song Creed. Incredible song. I debated putting this on this list because the original was just
stone cold
amazing.
Right.
Although Third Day and Brandon Heath did a pretty good job.
Yes, I agree they did a good job.
Believe in God the Father, Almighty Maker of Heaven
Hammer, dulcimer, and all.
Yes. Whenever you add a hammer, dulcimer into any song, phenomenal.
Amazing. Absolutely amazing. Go check out nice. That cover. If there's any cover I recommend on this release, it's that one for yeah. sure.
And Third Day is just
Third
phenomenal.
Day is a tremendous Christian rock band, so that'll be my number four. My number three, another Rich Mullins cover. You had this album growing up. I remember the song growing up. Another song by Rich Mullins on his, that Creed was on his first songs album.
Right.
His second songs album, this song, Hope to Carry On, originally by Rich Mullins, but done by Cayman's Call. Great cover.
Yeah, they do a lot more with it because Rich usually just is Rich.
Yes, so, it really is just Rich.
Right.
But yeah, no, it's a tremendous cover. And I think, I forget the guy's, I think his name is, lead singer's name is Derek. And he, I think he originally sat with Rich Mullins performing this song.
Okay.
But did not. But when it was released, it was well after Rich's death, of course. So.
Oh, I got a little trivia.
Oh, yeah?
Derek and the Dominoes.
Derek and the Dominoes.
Right. Who is the lead singer of Derek and the Dominoes?
Derek. Huh? Derek.
I believe it's Eric Clapton.
Is that right?
I believe so, yes.
No, Derek.
No, I believe it's Eric Clapton, yeah. Derek and the Dominoes.
Derek and the Dominoes. I like that. So.
Yeah. Huh, I think it's okay. Lola or...
Oh, no. Wait, no.
Am I wrong?
That song, the song Lola, I remember was from a band called The Kinks.
Yes.
Okay.
But so there's a song similar to that.
Similar to it, okay.
Right, that's done by Derek and the Dominoes, but it's actually Eric Clapton.
Now, I also enjoy Weird Al Yankovic's cover of Lola when he called it Yoda.
Yes.
So that was...
Wow.
I love Weird Al. An awesome dude. Awesome. So yeah, he doesn't actually cover. He just writes parodies, and it makes him extremely funny.
Yeah.
So, yeah, number three there. I Hope to Carry On.
That's good.
By Cayman's Call, originally by Rich Mullins. This next one, number two, is a song by Toto. Can you guess what song I'm talking about?
Africa.
Africa.
Yeah.
Do you know what cover I'm going to put up on here?
Yes.
Toto's?
Benji?
Weezer. Who's Benji? Benji?
Benji? Well, Toto, Benji.
Well, Weezer was okay.
Weezer.
I bet you this is a cover that nobody's heard before, except for, I don't know, a select few. But this is a band, this is from a Christian rock band called Reliant K. They covered Africa. Absolutely incredible cover.
I love Reliant.
That's good. You don't like that one? Well, you're a big Toto fan, though.
Are they saying, I guess it rains down Africa, or God bless the rains down Africa?
I thought it was
I bless the rains down Africa.
I bless the rains,
yeah. Now, vampires.
Right. Now, there is a radio station, I believe, in Africa that the
plays it year, nonstop, 24/7.
Right.
In Africa. Yeah, absolutely crazy.
Yeah.
So, yeah, my personal favorite cover of Africa, I mean, and, well, I mean, with harmonies and all, I mean, they do a tremendous job getting all the harmonies together. So, yeah, I liked Reliant K cover of Africa by Toto. I originally had this up on my list, but then...
Oh, you're adding it?
I lost it for some reason, so...
How can you lose a list?
Or, I mean, I lost the song on my list. I don't know why, so.
It's like that list when the wife tells you, get if they have five eggs, get laundry detergent. So you come back with laundry detergent. Well, they had the five eggs. You didn't say get five eggs, but you just said.
Yeah, they had five eggs. So yeah, all got laundry detergent.
Get five eggs, get laundry detergent.
Oh, my. my
goodness. Oh, that's funny. So. Yeah.
That's why you don't send men shopping.
No, you don't. No, sorry. So, all right.
Or the joke that we had all along.
Wait, what?
We're going to True Value.
To get some bread, yeah.
No, or we were going to True Value, and then we asked Mom, do you want us to pick up anything? She goes, bring back a loaf of bread. And we both looked at each other like, what?
Well, she didn't hear that we were going to True Value. Right. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah.
But then she got us back because what happened when we went to a next hardware store, Menards?
They had bread there.
They
have bread at Menards.
So she was a foreseer. She was a foreseer.
So Mom won that round. She got the last laugh on that one. So
yes.
Good for her.
I think a lot of people may not be surprised at this number one. It's a cover. Duh. this episode's all about covers, but this song became wildly popular once this band covered it, especially this particular singer covered it. His name is David Draymond, and he is from the band Disturbed. They covered Simon and Garfunkel's "The Sound of Silence,"
ooh,
and made it 100,000 times better.
I disagree. Now, I like
listen him. To the whole song, first of all. Well, this is only a snippet of it, but listen to the whole song, please.
But I like the one that Tim Faust and Peter Hollins does.
Oh, okay. No, that was pretty good. Their cover was good.
Right.
Because it is all a cappella. Let's get this right. There, it was all a cappella. But
Tim Faust from Home Free, Peter Hollins, and they did it together. Just those two did Sound of Silence.
Yeah, they check out that cover too. But
Disturbed sounds really good. They did a great job.
David just did the instrumentation, the mood. It was poignant to the mood of the song, and
I'm sure it
incredibly more dramatic and dark.
His voice was just amazing.
It encased the sound of that.
And the song is actually written as a dark song anyway.
Well, that's the thing, is that, I mean, the song, or the original song by Simon and Garfunkel was pretty depressing, but, I mean, it's like...
Well, they you'd took have that. Depressing. Did you see an afro on a white guy? That was depressing.
Christ alive.
I mean, Garfunkel looks like death warmed over. I mean, come on. I'd be depressed, too.
Can't say that, actually,
now. Yeah, it's...
No.
Too late.
That's all right.
We don't care.
Yeah, come at me, bro.
Did you not hear the intro?
Oh, they didn't.
They weren't here during the intro. That's right. They probably weren't. No, the intro, of course, means...
That's why
we like to express our opinion, and we don't give a rip what people think.
That's right. So
there you go.
Anyway.
That's why it's
a podcast. We're still in a hot LZ.
That's the reason why I pulled out that intro is because we are in a hot LZ. Oh my god, it's so hot in here.
Yeah,
well, not here in Loving's Moon, but it's hot outside. So come into Loving's Moon karaoke tonight at 9 o'clock. We'll be here partying and getting the show started. So coming on in, good drinks, and it's nice and cold in here. Get yourself some refuge out from that hot weather. Snipes, KanEquip Girl for both of them. I'm JB Surge. We'll talk to you whenever. I don't know.
We'll come out to the ballpark and we can talk to you.
Yeah, you'll hear me at Clint Leitner Field. But keep up on our Facebook page, Power Surge Media. We'll post updates there on our next episode. Until then, we'll see you. Bye.
Bye.
Thanks for listening to Uncaged. Tune in next week for more. This has been brought to you by Loving's Moon, Tim and Jerry's Auto Sales, Garden Bowl, American Gratitude, Patrick Dugan's Coffee House, and AAA Loans and U-Haul.